Hello, and welcome to a new EasyDigitals.com video tutorial. Remember, you can get all of our high-quality Photoshop and Photoshop Elements templates at EasyDigitals.com. Just click on the Products button. And don't forget to sign up for our monthly newsletter. We give away free templates and tutorials each and every month, along with product update info and coupons. Okay, Kim, what easy tutorial are you going to show us today?
Okay, in part one and two of the brushes tutorial, I showed you how to load and use brushes. And now I want to show you how to do something a little bit more customized. This cover that I created for Industrial Grunge is inspired by covers that I saw on some popular video games. The brushes used on these video games were from bittbox.com, and I'm going to provide a link underneath this tutorial on how you can download those brushes. But basically, these are the brushes that were used for these popular video games, and I think they're really a cool effect, so I'm going to show you how to do that today. So this is going to be our end result that we're looking for, something similar to this. And I'm going to go ahead and move this out of the way. I'm going to use this for inspiration, but you won't be able to see it on the screen because it's off out of my window. And this is the photo that I'm going to be working with right here. It is an extracted image. I have a white background on. I show in my other tutorials how to extract a photo and how to give it this popular HDR look, which I use Topaz Adjust to do, and I'll put a link to that on the bottom of this tutorial as well. You can also create the HDR effect in other ways with Photoshop, but I'm not going to get into that today, but you can do a search on that and find some other ways to do that. Okay, let's go ahead and get started. I have my work window up. When you have your move tool selected, I like to have auto select layer and show transform controls selected. You need to go ahead and have your spatter brushes loaded, and I do have mine loaded. So I went ahead and pressed on the brush tool, and I'm coming up here, and you can see that I have my brushes right here. If you want to see the thumbnails a little bit easier, you can come over here and click this arrow and come down where it says large thumbnail, and then you can see them easier. And these are the brushes that we're going to be working with right here. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started. What I like to do is go ahead and add a new layer for each brush that I use, and I also like to have my white layer on so that I can see exactly what's going on. So I'm going to go ahead and pick a brush to start with. I'll go ahead and choose this one. This picture is pretty small, so when it first comes in, you just see this little cross. And if you want the brush to show up, you have to press the left bracket, so it reduces the size of the brush so it starts to show up. So I'm going to go ahead and come over here. I want to show you how you can rotate the brushes. You come over to this little icon, click on brush tip shape, and then this will allow you to turn the brush. So I'm just going to basically turn it here and get it how I want it. And move this out of the way. And go ahead and add my spatter mark right here. Oops, edit, undo. Okay, I do want it black, so I'm going to come over here and swap those, or you can reset them. Black is on top. I'm going to go ahead and add my first splatter. And I want it a little bit darker, so I'm just going to hit it a couple times. And I want it underneath my player, so I'm going to drag it down. And that's my first spatter. And what you can see, though, is that these spatters have a little bit of extra design in them besides the spatter. And so it's causing like this line up here. So you may need to use a mask or an eraser to get rid of this as you move along. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is just erase it right now, so that I don't have to worry about which layer it's on later. And I'm going to get a soft brush, and I'm just going to erase what I don't want. And now I'm going to add my next spatter, and so I'm going to go ahead and add a new layer. This time I want to use red, and I'm just going to choose a color out of his uniform and then make it a little bit brighter. Choose my brush, pressing my left bracket to make this smaller. I'm going to go ahead and add this one back here. I have to click on my brush tool, not my eraser tool. And I actually want to turn this one a little bit more. And I'm going to go ahead and move it, erasing that part I don't want to show. And I'm just going to move along here, add a new layer. A few of the layers are on top. Those kind of give it that 3D look. This is going to be right off of his uniform. Oh, I still need to click my brush tool, not my erase tool. If I put something underneath that, that'll show up better. So I'm going to add black underneath that. I'm just going to move that with my move tool. Even rotate it if I want to. And basically, some parts of it look like they're on top and some parts look like they're underneath. Just little details is what's really going to make it look good. But I'm just going to go ahead and add a little bit more detail here. And if the splash gets a little bit too much, you can always erase parts of it. I'm going to go ahead and turn this one. Put it above the player. Move it a little bit. And you can just keep adding to it until you get it the way you like it. And then what you can go ahead and do is save a copy as a JPEG and add it to the template, which is what we're going to do on the next tutorial. So stay tuned.
Hey, that was easy. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions about this tutorial or any of our products, you can always reach us at easydigitals.com. Have yourself a creative day.